One of the worst things you can do when checking a bag is packing your valuables in them. During the first 9 months of last year alone, there were more than 2.25 million occurrences of lost or damaged luggage. And the crazy part is, that stat is just for the 10 busiest airports in the US. And that's not the only thing that can go wrong when checking luggage. In today's video, I'll be diving into the 10 things you should definitely not do when checking a bag. Let's go.
Dream vacations start here.
So why should you not pack valuables in your check bag? I think the answer is obvious, but as a general rule, you should never pack anything in your check bag that you can't live without or has a high monetary value. As I mentioned in the opening, there are millions of bags that go lost or damaged each year, and so if you have items in your check luggage that are of high value to you, pack them in your carry-on or personal item bag instead. And if you think the airline will reimburse you if your bag goes missing or damaged, think again. Unless you have a list of the items in your bag along with receipts, you are likely not going to get compensated, or at least not at the true value of your lost or damaged items. If you find yourself needing to check a bag at the gate, which usually occurs when the airplane is run out of overhead storage space, be sure to remove items such as laptops, tablets, smartphones, prescription medications, and probably most importantly, your passport. Pricey souvenirs that you have purchased on your trip should be packed in your carry-on as well. Or if they're too large, then I would consider having those items shipped home, and be sure to get the insurance coverage on your package as well as a tracking number so you're covered in case of loss or breakage. The second thing not to do when checking a bag is packing items that are on the TSA's prohibited list. This would include anything flammable like fireworks, matches, and lighters. Also, did you know that you can't pack certain kinds of batteries in your checked luggage? Dry batteries like AA or AAA batteries are okay to pack, but loose, uninstalled lithium batteries have to be packed in your carry-on. This could be camera batteries, power banks, and cell phone battery charging cases, to name a few. Other prohibited items are electronic cigarettes and vaping devices. Those can go in your carry-on. And also prohibited on many airlines are hoverboards. I do have a whole playlist of videos covering TSA rules that go into much greater detail. So if you need help knowing which bag to pack something in, I'll have that playlist linked in the description. Moving on to number 3, don't use a non-TSA approved lock. I know a lot of you like to lock up your checked luggage, and for good reason, but if you're going to use a lock that is TSA approved. If you use a non-TSA lock and your bag needs to be physically inspected, the TSA will just cut off the lock and your bag will be left unlocked for the remainder of its journey, and there's no guarantee that all your belongings will be waiting for you at baggage claim. Getting a TSA approved lock will allow the TSA to unlock and lock your luggage with a master key, ensuring that your luggage stays locked until you pick it up. I'll have some links to some TSA approved locks in the description if you need to pick some up for your next trip. Number 4, don't leave any loose ends. I know sometimes you can be in a hurry to get packed up for your flight, and in the process, you leave something hanging out of your suitcase. This could be something like straps, shoelaces, or other clothing. These items can easily get caught on the conveyor belt at the airport and either get destroyed or lost, so make sure you double check that nothing is hanging outside your suitcase before you check it. Number 5, don't book a tight connection. I've mentioned this before in another video, but just because you might be able to make a tight connection, it doesn't mean your luggage can. The shorter the connection time, the bigger the risk that your luggage won't make the connecting flight with you. If you're flying on a larger plane that is carrying hundreds of people, think about how many bags that are being stored under the plane and the time it can take to unload all of those bags. Then once those bags have been unloaded, it has to go through a sorting process and then loaded onto your next flight. This process can easily take 45 minutes or more, depending on the size of the airport and the time of day. When checking a bag, I like to give myself at least an hour between connecting flights and 2 hours for a connecting international flight, especially if you know your connection will require you to reclaim and recheck your luggage between flights. Moving on to number 6 for things not to do when checking a bag is don't put your liquids and valuables in a bad spot. Packing these items near the outside of the suitcase can easily break or explode when tossed around by the baggage handlers. This is especially true if you have to gate check a carry-on and you end up leaving your liquids in one of the outer pockets. Cushioning your liquids in the main compartment of your luggage is the safer bet. Something else you can try is taping your liquid bottles with duct tape and placing them in a well-cushioned plastic bag. If you're transporting alcohol, roll up the bottles in layers of clothing or bubble wrap, or you can purchase something like the inflatable Vinny bag to keep your liquids and other valuables safe. Number 7 on the list is don't travel with an unmarked bag. Since a lot of luggage can look similar to each other, it's not uncommon for someone to grab the wrong bag by mistake. So to avoid this, add something to your bag that will not only help you identify your bag from the rest, but also prevent someone from picking up your bag instead. Try using a unique bag tag, a sticker, or even a ribbon to make your luggage stand out. Number 8, don't get too close to the weight limit. Most US airlines will allow your checked bag to weigh up to 50 pounds, but if you go over that limit, you'll be hit with extra fees. To prevent this from happening to you, purchase a small luggage scale like this one to help make sure you're within the weight limit. But don't get too close to that 50 pounds because the luggage scales at the airport may not be the most accurate. Number 9, don't gate check a bag if it can fit under your seat. If the plane you're flying on runs out of overhead storage space, then that means you'll need to check your bag at the gate, which is typically free. However, if you're carrying a backpack or small bag that can fit under the seat, that might be a better option for you as you won't have to wait around for another piece of luggage at baggage claim. And number 10, don't pack all your clothes in your checked bag. Obviously, if you get to your destination and find that your luggage is missing, it could be a day or two before the airline is able to get your luggage back to you, or maybe not at all. And so having an extra change of clothes would be helpful. But yet another reason to pack extra clothes is because you might get cold. Airports can be chilly, and even on the plane itself, your seatmate could decide to blast the air vent, so having some extra clothes to put on will make you more comfortable. And hey, make sure you check out the links in the video description for more resources and give the video a like if you found this information helpful. Thank you so much for watching, and I look forward to catching you in a future video.